Jeff Manasso is covering the missing Flight 370 for Fox News Radio. And whenever you have a jet of this size disappear under catastrophic conditions, very seldom do you not have all kinds of conspiracy theories. Thinking of TWA 800, Egypt Air 990, Pan Am 103. We're still discussing those crashes all these years later. Let's get the absolute latest from Jeff. He joins us now on our turnkey.pro answer line. Good morning, Jeff. What's the latest information this morning?
Well, the latest, there's really only speculation as to what happened. And as you mentioned, whether or not this plane just completely disappeared or just, you know, disintegrated perhaps at cruising altitude would suggest sudden catastrophe, catastrophic failure, or possible explosion. The only thing that we can really compare this to is like Lockerbie, that flight, or the Indian Air India jetliner in 1985 over the Atlantic Ocean that exploded. But the fact of the matter is there's no debris yet. What was thought was a life raft or a door to this missing jetliner in the ocean turned out to be nothing. There are dozens of ships from countries throughout the region. We're there. NTSB investigators are there ready if needed at a moment's notice to help out in the investigation. But the fact of the matter is that there are a lot of questions and very, very few answers at this hour.
What kind of help is America sending over there?
Investigators from the NTSB, and we've also got a ship in the region.
If a plane of this size and this kind of normal integrity and technological advances disappears off the map just like that, it's catastrophic. And I would think it has to be one of two things: an explosion that takes it out, done, so the pilots are dead as it explodes, or the pilots are not involved, but there's malfeasance or incompetence, they're out of the cockpit, and all of a sudden the plane just, you know, starts augering in. It has to be one of those two. What would be the other option? Anything?
Well, perhaps terror. We don't know.
But that'd be the explosion. That's what I mean.
Yeah, right. Every theory at this point is open. I mean, they're Malaysian officials say that they're not closing the door on any theory at this point. They just have no idea. I mean, these planes are actually they're one of the safest types of jets in service today. Commercial aircraft. The only previous fatal crash or incident involving a 777 was last year in San Francisco when the Asiana Air flight clipped the
pilot error,
the seawall, and that was pilot error.
So in this case, there is no mayday call. They were already at cruising altitude, 30,000 feet?
35,000 feet, Amy, and no distress signal. And that's why experts say that suggests a sudden catastrophic failure.
All right.
According to, go ahead.
Two guys with fake passports, stolen passports.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm sure that everybody, Interpol, our guys, their guys, everybody's running these two guys down.
Yeah.
In that case, if it was a coordinated attack, my only thought is they have to get themselves, if they're carrying the explosives, if it's not in the luggage, they have to get themselves close enough to the cockpit so it's catastrophic from that from the cockpit's perspective, so there's no radio call, no SOS, no mayday, the computer ends, the black box goes dead, it all falls into the sea of Thailand, and it could be weeks or months before we find this.
Yeah, if at all. And everything that we're talking about is total speculation. I mean, the one of the major focuses right now is on those two passengers that used stolen passports. Who were they? Were they terrorists? Were they hijackers? Or were they just people trying to sneak into China on stolen passports? We just don't know. It is kind of alarming, John and Amy, to know that other countries are out there and not checking these stolen documents against Interpol or these vast databases that would have pinged these two people right away. There are no direct flights from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, to the U.S., and that's why the U.S. was not involved, and that's why they weren't checked. But it is interesting that other countries let some of these incidents and stolen documents go unchecked.
And what's strange is the tickets were purchased at the same time using these stolen passports. One was stolen from an Italian, the other one from an Australian. Do you know anything more?
That's all we know. And we're trying to track them down. We heard from Republican Rep. Congressman, New York Congressman Peter King, who says that there's images of these people in video boarding the plane, walking through the airport. So I'm sure that facial recognition and other techniques are being used to try and determine who exactly these two men aboard this flight were. But that is really the only lead at this point. There's radar that suggests that this plane made some movement and perhaps tried to turn or turn around. But you focus in on that radar and what that means for those ships out there in the Sea of Thailand. It means thousands of square miles.
Mm-hmm.
So the search is vast and wide, and there is no debris. There is no black box. There is no ping for a black box. It's shrouded in mystery.
Jeff, we'll leave it there. Thank you, sir, for the update. We appreciate it. We'll call on you again soon.
You bet.
Jeff Manasso reporting for Fox News on our turnkey.pro answer line.